Yo.
What?
All right. So, we got the final part to Carl versus Steve, all the insults.
Yeah, man. It was funny, man. This stuff has been funny.
It was very funny. Very, very funny. I imagine there's been a lot more insults behind the scenes. You can only imagine what goes on behind the microphone.
Yeah, man. Countless, countless cut downs.
Yeah.
Carl.
Yeah.
Probably worse.
Yeah.
All right, so you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
150 quid, yeah. What, on gift vouchers?
Yeah.
To spend at the same places?
Mm.
I'd have to say, though, I mean, it's not a very inventive gift, is it?
It's whoever came up with
it,
though.
It's a lovely thought. It's wonderful to have £25 that I can only spend in two places I never go in. But, I'm not looking a gift horse in the mouth. It is a treat.
He spoke to Jonathan Ross like he was a normal person.
From someone whose dad buys him a spade for Christmas, I thought you'd be grateful. So ungrateful, really.
Yeah.
Because I can't remember a time my dad bought me anything. It's always my mum who bought it, and my dad would give her the money.
Yeah.
You got Ricky who's lost his go-kart. You've had a video bought for you, and you're still not happy. I just think it's selfish.
Now, it's intriguing to me because here's a film called Freaks, featuring real-life freaks, and you're sort of a bit nonplussed by it.
Just because it wasn't, because it's built up. If you call a video Freaks, you've got to make sure that there's some good stuff on there.
Yeah. What were you disappointed about? Was it that?
Because there was a few things on it, right? There was a woman who said she was half man, half woman. And it's like, well, you're not, are you? It was just like she had some makeup on. I thought, well, that's rubbish. And then there was a woman who could eat using her feet. That isn't that freaky. Do you know what I mean? She's not hungry, she looks normal.
Yeah.
And that's when I was thinking. I mean, I'm not being, right, Steve, you know I'm not being funny.
Oh, here we go.
No, but I'm just saying, if that woman wasn't eating and you were sat next to her in that film,
yeah,
I'd probably be sort of drawn to you more than her. I know you hate me saying it, but there's no point sort of pretending. Do you know what I mean?
Oi, Muttley, what are you sniggering about?
That face. you mean there were things in it that were less? What are you saying?
I'm just saying.
Play a record. Seriously, I'll slap you. I'm going to slap you live on air.
Yeah, but you always get.
I'm slapping you live on air. I swear to God.
Play a song.
It's happening again, Steve.
What's happening?
It's going all wrong. Yeah. We're talking rubbish.
Are we?
Yeah.
We should have played two in a row.
He's having a go, isn't he?
Blimey. Can I just kiss and make up with Carl?
No, that is.
No, let me just kiss my kiss.
Yeah, but it doesn't. Next week, it'll be the same again. What? It doesn't mean anything. It's like saying
it's
sorry.
Oh.
It's on the lips. Go on. He's
Carl. Carl.
Get off it! I've never. Carl has gone a absolute shade of purple, straining not to have merchants.
There's no point, Steve.
No.
There's no point.
No, just shake. Just shake and make up.
Shake what, Rick?
There you go. All friends, sit down. That's lovely. That's a lovely moment.
Shake what?
Half woman.
No. Not true.
It happened. Apparently, it was
impossible.
It was in the Daily Mail. Right?
Okay.
The Victorian Ape Woman was a name.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I christened this thing Victorian Ape Woman. Well, we thought Sandra. No, I'm calling it Victorian Ape Woman.
She was about 4 foot.
No, didn't happen.
She had lovely thick black hair on her head and on the back of her legs.
Yeah.
All right.
Same stockings.
Let's have a look.
And she didn't need a bustle because of her huge ape-like arse sticking out the back of her dress.
She was good at reading and sewing.
Good, because they didn't have opposable thumbs, so,
She could speak three languages.
Yes.
She was
human, monkey, and monkey-human.
20 offers of marriage. Does that annoy you, Steve?
Absolute twaddle.
Right,
right. More rubbish than your soul weighing an ounce.
Let's leave
a Victorian
it there.
Monkey
Let's
woman.
Leave it there, then.
See you next week with some more twaddle.
What the hell was that? Victorian monkey woman.
Peace Train. Isn't that brilliant? Cat Stevens. Now, well, I've sort of enjoyed the last sort of, you know, hour or so after the disappointment of the Sonys. I think we are going to give up, to be honest. Do another week and then shoot off.
Yeah, knock it on the head.
Okay. We are doing it for a laugh anyway, but...
If they're not going to reward us for that, then...
Do you know what I mean?
It's not really worth it.
But I'll tell you what could... But what about this? Carl, can you find out who was on the panel? Can you?
But what difference does it make?
Well, I want you to interview. I want you to phone them up and I want to tell them why they didn't think our show was.
Yeah, let them explain themselves.
Just explain themselves. They've got to stand by their convictions. Find them all. Track them down. There's probably about
yeah,
three.
But what do you expect then?
I want to tell the truth.
No, you're right. The monkey knew should have, you know, done the job for you.
I just want people. Wrong. I don't want them to be. I don't want them to sit in a room and hide. I want the three people on our panel. I'll find them out to say we didn't vote for you because we thought. It was shoddy, amateurish, annoying, there was too much swearing. I'll go, fair enough, well done, mate. You. We didn't vote for you because Carl's voice is an irritant. Okay? Okay? Well done, mate. You're alright. We didn't vote for you because, Gervais, you're a fat, useless git who understands nothing about broadcasting.
And you might know something.
Yeah. And I'll go, right, I'm not so happy with that, but at least you told the truth.
Mm-hmm.
But... Get them on the phone. Find out from Andrew.
None of them have mentioned me, which is good.
I know, yeah.
Think I'm pretty good.
Yeah, yeah. They probably all love Steve.
Mm. No one likes to pick on an invalid, though. Do you know what I mean?
We got a player request here for, what's her name? Sonia, who's 18 today. We couldn't find William. It was really nothing worth Smith because... whoever is in charge of the library, I mean, they probably won an award for it, but, you know, she didn't ask for four non-blondes, so I found There Is a Light by the Smiths. So, a week to go.
Yeah.
I'm not.
Is that Steve saying something? Steve didn't like that.
That's Feeder, Just the Way I'm Feeling, on XFM. 104.9, Ricky Gervais, Steve Merchant, Claire Sturgis. Well, he's defying me. He's not calling in. We're going to give out his number and he's not calling in. That's even more annoying. Who does he think he is?
I don't know who he thinks he is. I'll tell you who he is.
Yeah.
He is a little bold Mancunian.
Let's never let him forget that.
I don't know who he thinks he is, but there's the fact.
Just, Carl, call in because you're annoying me and Steve. He's been slagging you off as well, Steve.
Well... Go on, what's
in the week, you know, he was slagging you off. I mean, in the week, I was joining in and laughing along, but now I'm thinking now I'm thinking that you're more on my side than he is.
Thanks very much, Riff. I'm glad to see you come round.
I was in the pub with him and Johnny.
All right, so there's a little audience, good.
And he went, have you seen Men in Black 2? I went, no. He said, have you, Johnny? He went, no. He went, oh, there's a thing in it that looks just like Steve. And I went, what? He went, it's a thing, he's got really gangly arms and bulbous eyes and it just works really fast in the aliens registration thing. And I went, all right. I said, well, bring that up Saturday. Since he's not here, you know, what do you think of that?
The reason is that I think the problem I have with is this, that if I was to say things like that about Carl, I'd destroy him. He'd be a broken man after I'd finish with him.
Call in, Carl, or Steve's going to say a few things about you.
I'm going to get a couple of home truths out there.
I can't believe it. I cannot believe it. Yeah, we were, at the time I was joining in, we were having, you know, slagging you off on other things as well.
Sure.
But now
sure.
I'm thinking, yeah. Maybe
you were wrong.
Maybe I was taking the mickey out of the wrong person behind their back.
Gangly.
The phone's going. Play that. Break on.
Oh, it might be Carl.
XFM.
Wow, here's a bit of a turn up for the books. Carl Pilkington on the line.
Right.
Yeah, where you been?
I'm off ill, aren't I?
Right. Okay, what's the matter with you?
I just it's a bit bunged up and that, and got the shakes, got that sort of that shaky thing to get.
Yeah, that's because you didn't eat last time when Suzanne was at work.
Yeah, well, I think that's what brought it on. Plus, she was away in the week, and I put some wet jeans on. And that's, I think that's what caused the problem.
Well, when did you put them on your head?
No, they were just on the maiden, and the legs felt dry, but they
just
were
on the what? On the what? Have you got the maiden? What was she doing there? What do you mean?
On the maiden that you put clothes on.
What?
Your clothes horse.
Maiden.
Your clothes horse.
Well, yeah.
Clothes horse.
Right, okay, so you put wet jeans on, yeah?
So that's why I'm ill on that. I've been having a good time, I've been watching the football.
Wet jeans on.
So you're just sitting at home watching telly where you could have been sitting here?
Well, I would have been better off there because I've got a chair there. I've got no chair at home at the moment, because I sold it last week.
Why did you sell a chair? What, you only have one chair? What?
Look, can't we just, I just was calling up to let you know I was alright and that.
We're not interested in that, we want to know about the chair.
I sold it, I had a little two-seater, and I sold it because I'm getting a new one, but I've got to wait another month.
So you've got to sit on the floor for a month? So you sold a chair before you had another one?
Well, she might not have wanted to buy it in a month or something. So I got rid of it whilst I could, she was alright, bloody. We'll talk about that next week.
Oh, you're gonna be in next week? I look forward to that then, that's a dynamite piece of radio to tune in for, the day Carl sold a chair. Brilliant.
Alright. So you alright then? It's going alright?
But why did you take this long to call? We asked you to call since the very beginning, we've been phoning you, why is your phone being switched off?
I heard the beginning of the show, I thought, yeah, it's going alright, the air and stuff. Turned it off.
You turned it off!
No, I put a tape in though, because even though I'm ill, I'm still showing an interest in it.
Well, you're not, if you're watching football and shaking.
I'll listen back to it later, so I hope you haven't been dissing me.
No. Right?
Definitely not.
Don't listen back to it, it's not worth it, but we haven't been dissing you, no.
No, I've just been watching, bit of football, right?
Did you watch the Monkey Programme last night? You told us to watch the Monkey Programme, we all stayed and watched the Monkey Programme.
Alright, wasn't it?
Rubbish, wasn't it? Obviously not half chimp, half human.
I mean, they missed out a lot of the interesting bits.
They didn't have any interesting bits. Those are the bits that you made up to make it more interesting.
The bits that I told you about 3 months ago before they decided to make the programme.
Yeah.
What were the bits that you came up with?
Well, they missed out the bits about, you know, the zookeeper.
Right, there wasn't a zookeeper, yeah, go on.
Well, there was, but they left that bit out.
Well, okay, fine. And they left out the bit where it ran from there in 1975.
In terms of those that did research, they actually went and filmed it, you read it on the internet.
Yeah, yeah.
Chances are you're the one with the facts wrong.
Yeah, I think they also left out the bit when it jumped over 3 double-decker buses on a motorbike.
On Evel Knievel's motorbike.
Yeah. So, I can't believe it. I cannot believe it. Not only do you not bother turning up, but you turn off the radio and start watching football.
I turned it off, but I've recorded it. I'll listen back later and sort of...
Well, what good is that?
Sort of, I like to keep it in shape and that. I'll have a word next week.
All right. If you receive any phone calls from people you don't know, we don't know anything about that. Instantly, we don't know why that is happening. That is just going to be a weird, spooky thing, so...
And don't bother telling the story about Men in Black 2 either, because I don't think people will be interested.
Actually, on the subject of Men in Black 2...
What?
Have you seen that, Steve?
No, I haven't, Carl. Tell me about it.
You should see it.
Go on. Why?
Because there's this thing in it.
Go on. What, a stupid, bald, Mancunian tosser?
No, weirder than that.
There isn't anything weirder than that.
Hey guys, it was gangly.
Keep talking.
You've got to see it, because you wouldn't believe out the likeness and that. You've got to see it out
tonight. Right.
It's not as weird, it had a normal voice, right?
Yeah.
He's done you and he's not even here!
I'll tell you what, mate, it ain't worth coming in next week.
Oh, stay on the line, Carl, play a record player. Kings of Leon, Molly's Chambers. What do you think of that, Carl?
Damn, he did look like it.
There's a surprise.
Oh,
another insightful remark.
Steve is not a fan now. Not only does he know you've been slagging him off behind his back.
No, I wasn't slagging Steve. If you get it out on the DVD tonight, you'll know I'm not slagging you off. It could be your brother.
I know the fact that it makes it worse, but he's been, you're going to go. Oh, he wasn't slagging me off. It does look like me. I do think I'm an alien. I love the fact that you hope Steve will go, he's got a point. It's a spitting image. Yeah.
I am, seriously, Carl, I'm really angry. I'm so angry with you at the moment.
You haven't seen it yet?
No, I know, because I know what it's going to be, and I'm just,
why?
I'm fuming. I'll tell you why I'm angry, because he doesn't do it in jest.
No, but what do you think it's going to look like? What do you think this thing's going to look like?
It's going to look ludicrous. It's not going to look anything like me, but no, he's going to like pretend it does. Go on, what? Go on.
No, it does look like you.
Yeah, of course it does. And you looked like the Human Z.
Well,
I mean, to be honest, you did a bit, Carl. You walk like him, you're bald like him, you got a sort of gormless face like him. Any more?
I don't smoke. That does. Arguing with you, I'm not well on that.
Oh, you're not well.
What exactly is wrong with you? You whinger.
Well, it's just, do you know, like I always tell you about the restless leg syndrome I've got. It's like yeah. That, but all over.
So you're just shaking around the house?
I'm just, yeah.
What do you look like? Elvis? What are you doing? You're shaking around the house.
I'll tell you, with your bald head, you're probably like an enormous vibrator.
Oh, God.
That's what you probably look like if you strip naked.
It could be Steve's brother. That thing.
Yeah, I remember that from the movie too.
Yes, I wasn't even thinking about that monster. Nah. Or that alien.
And the bug eyes.
Ellie just like him. Well, did he have glasses? I don't think he had glasses.
No.
It was missing glasses. And it had too many arms. If he just had two arms and a pair of glasses. Oh, shit. Yeah, that was a.
That's stupid. Yeah, man.
They go at Steve hard. Like,
they really do.
Him and Ricky, or Carl and Ricky. It just, yeah, you know, Steve handles it well, though.
Yeah, Steve does. Now, Steve doesn't always have the best of jokes. You know what I'm saying?
No.
But Carl definitely wins that battle versus Steve, in my opinion.
Yeah, Carl won. Definitely.
Carl won that battle.
I mean, the last one just, that was a TKO, and I just like,
Like, I mean, if you heard Steve, Steve was like calling him the same stuff Ricky calls him. I'm like, come on, man. Like, yeah. You gotta, like, come on, man.
Talked about his bald head and shaped like a fucking orange.
Yeah.
And his meek accent.
Yeah.
And his wild, crazy theories. But once you get past that, it's like, what the hell? That's all you know. Carl digs deep.
Yeah.
Carl digs deep. Carl said,
that's your insecurities, you know?
Motherfucker Carl said, are you scared that when you get along, when you get old, that you will be on your own?
Yeah.
It's like, damn. That shit will hurt me.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Yeah. Carl's diabolical.
Where it hurts, man. That's why nothing's off guard, man. Nothing is off guard.